Hey guys, welcome to another video. Today we're actually going to be doing a tutorial video. I noticed on the comments that most people are saying that my videos weren't tutorials, more like overviews. I'm going to be labeling them as overviews from now on because, I mean, that would be more accurate of a title. But this will actually be a tutorial. Today we're going to be building the entrance gate for Swede's Adventureland. That's the theme park that I'm going to be building for the next probably few years. And yeah, we're going to get started with a tutorial. Today we're going to be making the park entrance, turnstiles, maybe a few metal detectors, and then the park map. This will be the entrance to the first section of the park, which is the main village. It's going to have a jungle theme, so I'm going to be planting a bunch of trees to surround the builds. But first, we're going to be building the entrance. This is going to be a multi-dimension entrance. As you can see, the main entrance is going to be right here, but there's going to be turnstiles in between the entrance gate, and so we're going to be building a multi-dimensional entrance to the park. So you don't have to use this exact design, but I think it's pretty cool to use. So build these up five blocks. Five blocks get you a good, well, you'll see in a minute, but this will not be where the roof of the entrance will be. This is just going to make the entrance look really sick for the outside, because then we're going to be using slabs. And these slabs are going to go right here, and this is going to make it look like a jungle entrance. It's going to make it look really cool, and that's why I always say five blocks tall, because you can make a four block tall base and then have a five block tall exhibit. Just remember, we're not going to be putting slabs right there because that's going to be the actual entrance to the park, and we need to make a sign. So yeah, that is going to be your first, you'll remember, five blocks tall. Oak, you can use whatever wood you want. I think oak looks the best for a jungle theme. I mean, jungle wood itself is not too terrible, but also, like, I don't know, it just doesn't look as good as wood as the oak logs for a jungle theme. Then for this, we're gonna put oak wood blocks here. And that is going to be our basic pavilion for the turnstiles. And we're gonna put metal detectors over here as well. So next what we're going to do is we're going to make the walls, and as you can see, basically the walls are going to be mostly wooden, but of course we have the planks above. Just to make it more scenic and more outdoorsy, we're not going to make a full wall. I'm thinking maybe we do something a little bit nicer. So only do this, three blocks in a diagonal pattern. And I would make it different from this over here, just to make it a little bit more, just to make it more asymmetric. But that is going to be our design, and I think we're going to do some fences to make this look more decorative than it could be. So next thing for the floor is going to be oak wood planks. I'll explain why I've already placed oak wood planks over there, but that's going to lead into the path through the park and through the main village. The main village will have only one attraction. Most of it will be shops and restaurants and a marketplace and a fountain, but that will come in later videos. I'm planning on making a video where I build each. Some of them will be based on a tutorial that I've already seen, and I'll link the video, but this is completely custom design. I saw some other designs that looked cool, but this one was based off another build that was making a cyberpunk thing. And they reference the use of spires, which we will be using for this build. So to make spires, just put a fence on top of a block. this section will be where the sign will go. And there's a reason why I added, there's a reason why it's 3x3 for the most part, because that's how you make pixel block letters. We're going to be making a block letter for this park design. Basically, the block letters are going to be S and A for Swede's Adventureland, and then I'm going to replace it with banners once I figure out how to make banner letters, and I will do the tutorial for that when we change the sign, but for now we're just going to do letters. And we're going to do this design. This is 5 blocks tall, other is 5 blocks tall, this entire is 4 blocks tall of oak planks plus 2 oak slabs, and a 6 block tall mainframe. So that is going to be a basic park entrance. It will change once I get banner letters, but for now we are going to add the S . So that is going to be the basic S, and now I'm going to get the spruce planks that will make it happen and make it pop out. I like using planks for pixel letters because it allows you to do a lot more stylization. As you see, it looks ugly, but for right now I think that will be good enough to, well, it's not ugly because, I mean, it's literally what pixel letters are. They're just placeholders until I get the know-how to build banners with letters on them. I know there's a way to do it, but I've heard that certain letters can't be built. Like, I think Qs are not allowed, but I don't need Qs. Q is not in Swede's Adventureland. So that's going to be our pixel little sign for now, just as a placeholder. I think this S looks really cool. The A is not so cool, but I think the S is really cool. So that's going to be our sign. Now we are going to make turnstiles, and then we're going to make a short little metal detector. So what we're going to do for that is we're going to make a slight overhang out from the structure. A slight overhang for the structure. Has this really cool roof feel where the roof is different. Is on different layers, and I just like how the oak goes outward. And so we're going to be making a metal detector right here, and right here it's going to be a very small metal detector, but for the most part it's just going to be a dark concrete, gray concrete for metal detector. And we're going to be using terracotta, I believe. Terracotta. I wanted to use these glazed terracotta, but I guess they don't have a good color, so we're going to use wool instead. And then the lever and button on them. There's a lever right here. Here, then two buttons. And that is controlled by someone in the operation booth, which will be right here. We will be putting a villager right there as soon as I set it back to daytime. He will be the police officer for our operation center, and we'll just build out the path right here. We will give him a sign telling people that I'm going to do detection officer. We will be adding a disappear there in a second, but I gotta add lights in here. Luckily, lanterns are the best light for a jungle theme. And lanterns will be going right on these blocks here. What? Why is it not hanging? Oh, yeah. Usually lanterns are able to be hung on stuff. Oh, maybe this will help. Oh, I see. I see what's going on here. There we go. Forgot about the slabs for a second. So place this slab down in the middle of the three-block open space we made beforehand, and place a lantern. I think that looks pretty nice and decorative. So now we're going to make the turnstiles. The turnstiles are going to be made out of nether brick, I believe. Does nether brick have a gate? I don't think so. No. We'll do mangrove then. We need to make something that's darker, a little bit more contrasty. So that's going to be a turnstile. We're going to put a... we'll do spruce. There you go. Simple turnstile. Usually they have multiple fences, so we'll do that, like a little U shape. It's just four mangrove fences and a fence gate. I'll be posting all the materials you'll need. I'll count up all the materials you'll need and post it in the description. So if you want to see how much materials you're going to need for this design, then I'll give you all of the materials lists so you can get it all if you want to make this in survival. If you want to make this like a base entrance or something, a secure base entrance. That's nice to do. Later on, I'm going to be doing some redstone and command block wizardry. Command block wizardry to make this an actual metal detector. There is actually a way to do that. But for now, we're going to make a custom villager because I don't want my park employees to be nameless. So I'm gonna call this guy Harry Styles. Why? Cause I just thought of it when I was thinking of names. So that is Harry Styles. He's going to be our security officer for today. I really hope Harry Styles hasn't actually been arrested because that would be ironic. But anyway, that is going to be the park entrance with metal detectors and turnstiles with a sign. And the final thing we're going to be making is we're going to be making a park map that will be 9 blocks wide, and it will basically hold the map of the park. I don't think it needs to be 9 blocks wide. 1, 2, 3. I'll make it 9 blocks wide. It won't have to be this long, I don't think, unless the hypercoaster is an out and back one, which I'm thinking about making it. I'm thinking about making a giant hypercoaster, a 200-foot coaster, and that may need some land. So we're gonna be doing this using the park entrance spike as a... Forgot to add the fences. I'll make sure. Don't worry about it, guys. And yeah, so this will be the park map. Just fill this in with oak wood. It won't take that long, I promise. And yeah, the park map will just be viewable. We'll have a little staircase going up to it so you can see all of it when I start to add it. But I'm just going to put it in the middle area, and I'm going to put a little... I'm going to make a little platform to go up to view it, because it is going to be a big map, so you may need a platform to view it. And make sure that it doesn't block anything. We're going to be making it out of glass. And I'm going to make it out of just clear glass so that people can see. And I'm going to make it this high up. So that is going to be the viewing platform. And I'm going to make this better, I swear. Because right now it probably looks ugly. The way we're going to do that is with spruce trapdoors. That's gonna make it so that it looks not it looks non-ugly from the outside. And yeah. Okay, so and then to get up to here, we're going to be putting a oak block. And the way I think this is going to be the best way to do this, I think you can still place ladders on glass. If we can't, then we'll. Oh, yep. Good. If that wasn't going to work, my next block was probably going to be either iron or just light wool. But I do like the glass so that it's not blocking the map. And yeah. I'm going to add some light at the bottom so it's not. Because I'm going to make it enclosed. But not too enclosed. Just gonna add some fences here. And this will be so the map will start up here, and if we have to go down, because it will most likely go down, because that way, the more I build in that direction right there, the more I build in that direction over there, the more the map will probably go this would go down. So we're gonna need a map for all directions, but mostly want to start up top so we can make the full map go downwards. So, yes. We do not have. Well, I guess we can make a map real quick of this entrance here. And then, item frame. And we can make the starting map. So I'm going to put it right here. And I'm going to make a map of this area. Map 0. And then just make sure that that's all filled out. And that will give us a small starting spot. As you can see, this map is a little bit misleading because it is pointed that direction, which is kind of weird. But we will be making some stuff in that area. That's probably where the main village is going to go. This section of the park is going to go right there, and I'm thinking on using that hill as another part of the park, and there's also a lake over there. Right now, that is our first map, and then I'm going to make a chest. I'm going to make a chest right. I'm going to cover this up as well so that no one is nosy. This is going to be where we're going to put our map. We're going to put it right in the middle because we're going to be making a map guide in that chest, so we'll know how to place them once we start to expand the park. But anyway, this is the entrance to the park with a park map and viewing station. I will be posting all of the necessary blocks you need in the description. This is very easy. It's a very easy design to use oak wood and spruce wood, wood in general, that isn't hard to get. And I do want to focus on the turnstile wood because I use mangrove wood because it looks interesting, but if you can't make it out of this color, acacia wood and jungle wood will do as well. I'll post that in the description that you can use either mangrove, jungle, or acacia wood. Just something that's reddish in color to contrast from the brown is good enough. Birch wood, not that useful to make, is not that good contrast because it's kind of just a lighter beige colored wood. I use birch to make houses, and I will be definitely using birch in the future for item shops and gift shops in the park, but for right now, I would skip on the birch for right now. But anyway, that is our. And I'll also be including an anvil and villager egg, but of course I'll just say that if you're not gonna make this in creative mode, I'll put in the description that the optional idea is just to find a villager and a name tag. But of course, that is. Well, I'll make it day real quick so you can see the full picture. This is the area, and of course, if you really don't like how the metal detectors look, I think this will be I think this is a good idea. So the metal detectors kind of look ugly, so we're going to do this with spruce planks, and this will be the final step. I think this looks better. So now the metal detectors aren't completely out of the ordinary. You can still see them because of the buttons and stuff. Honestly, we don't really need the buttons. All we need is the lever. Does that make it look weird? I think it makes it look a little weird. I'm gonna keep the buttons, mostly because I don't want you guys to change up anything. But if you want to do spruce planks like that, spruce trap doors like that, instead of the buttons, then that's perfectly fine for you to do. Anyway, that is going to be the entrance for now. I'm going to figure out how to make banners letters later, but that is going to be our entrance for Swede's Adventureland with our little detection officer right there. This will be our this will be our entrance for the time being. So, like if you like, dislike if you don't, subscribe if you really like it, and I'll see you guys in the next video where we'll be making a gift shop and the bouncy block later on for the first attraction of the park. I'll see you guys later, I'll post the materials that you'll need in the description. Have a good one, and yeah, toodaloo.